Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Sunday of the 17th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. God is in His holy place. God who unites those who dwell in His house. He Himself gives might and strength to His people.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, let our response be, "Lord, I love your commands."
Lord, I love your commands.
I have said, O Lord, that my part is to keep your words. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Lord, I love your commands.
Let your kindness comfort me according to your promise to your servants. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight.
Lord, I love your commands.
For I love your commands more than gold, however fine. For in all your precepts I go forward, every false way I hate.
Lord, I love your commands.
Wonderful are your decrees, therefore I observe them. The revelation of your word sheds light, giving understanding to the simple.
Lord, I love your commands.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those who he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for you have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." "Do you understand all these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Again, this Sunday we have the parables on the kingdom. Of course, you have actually here almost four points to look at. No? But actually the first two, the buried treasure and the pearl of great price would basically have the same lesson. No? And then you have the third parable, which is the parable of the dragnet, which hauls in everything. No? And then finally you have Christ saying at the end, "Do you understand all these things?" And then he says, "Then every scribe who has been instructed, you know, must bring in from his storeroom both the new and the old." So pag nilaya natin yung tatlong punto, no, yung unang dalawang parable tungkol dun sa treasure, dun sa hidden treasure, at saka dun sa pearl of great price. And then yung pangalawang punto, pag nilaya natin yung tungkol dun sa lambat na nanghuhuli ng lahat ng isda. Tapos yung kahuli-hulihan na sinabi ng Panginoon na gamitin yung parehong bago at luma. No? Let us reflect on this. For our reflection, I'd like to reflect on this using, I guess, one of the basic dynamics or processes of Ignatian spirituality. You know, one of the things that we were told, no, when we were seminarians and later on even as priests when we were going on our annual retreat and spiritual direction. You know, one thing with Ignatius is that, especially in his spiritual exercises, one of the main goals of the process is for one to discover one's mission, God's will for one, for that person. What is one's mission? So that is really the basic, might say, one of the fruits of the spiritual exercises. And that goes through a very beautiful process of self-awareness, self-acceptance, and then beginning to reflect on Christ. Now, Christ, it's a very Christocentric spirituality. But I think what is really very central to it is that when one discovers one's mission, one dedicates oneself totally to that mission. And in a sense, diba, that pearl of great price and that hidden treasure is discovering what is God's will for me, what is God's mission for me, what is it that God wants me to do. Yun ho yung napakagandang layunin ng spiritual exercises ni San Ignacio de Loyola. Na sinasabi ng spiritual exercises, ang pinakamahalaga lahat sa buhay ay malaman ko ano ba yung katuturan ng ating buhay, ano yung purpose ng ating buhay, at ano ang ating mission. Diba sabi rin ni nung sikat na manunulat, si Mark Twain, dalawang araw ang pinakamahalaga sa buhay natin. Yung una ay yung araw na pinanganak tayo, at yung pangalawa ay yung araw kung kailan natin nalaman kung ano yung ating layunin sa buhay, ano yung purpose at mission natin sa buhay. And I think that is the pearl of great price. That is the hidden treasure for which we will sell everything, no, in order to be able to own this treasure and this pearl of great price. And that is the value of knowing God's mission for us, God's will for us. As Ignatius would say, the moment we discover God's will and mission, we give ourselves totally to the work, totally to achieving the mission that God wants us to do in our life. And that is our first point for reflection. Now, the second point for reflection is yung lambat, di ba? Sabi dito sa parable, ang lambat, pag tinapon mo yan, lahat huhulihin. Hindi siya mamimili, ito maganda itong isdan to, ito mataba, ito malaki, ito maliit. De, pero lahat yan, sinasama. At pagkatapos ng paghuli, dun lang hipaghiwa-hiwalayin, di ba? Kung ano yung pwede ng isda na hanguin or pwedeng maliit pa kaya hindi mo na gagamitin or hindi siya maganda. Pero paghihiwa-hiwalayin siya pagtagal-tagal, no? Siguro yan ay isang simbolo ng kaharian ng Diyos. Na ang kaharian ng Diyos ay hindi siya exclusive. That the kingdom of God is all-inclusive. And it invites everybody to the feast. It invites everybody to the kingdom of God. Wala siyang discrimination. And yet, I think pinapaalala sa atin nung parable na bagaman walang discrimination kasi lahat ay welcome, sa katapusan, merong pa rin paghuhusga. Merong justice sa katapusan. Kagaya ng sinabi ng parable last Sunday, di ba, na at the end of it, paghihiwalayin ang wheat sa weeds. Paghihiwalayin yan. Yung mabuti sa masama, maghihiwa-hiwalay yan. And again, this is an assurance for us. You know, in the midst of so many challenges going on all over the world, narinig nyo naman ho yung balita nitong nakaraang linggo, yung nangyayari sa Amerika, nangyayari dito sa atin, yun ay isang kumbaga ano, napakagandang hindi lang pagpalubag-loob kundi isang parang pagpapatatag ng kalooban natin na sa katapusan ang hustisya ng Diyos ang magwawagi. Kasi di kuminsan, di ba, nakakalumo, di ba? Sabi nga nila sa Tagalog, nakakapanlumo yung makita natin na parang nananaig ang kasamaan, nananaig ang kasakiman. And yet the parable assures us that the kingdom of God invites everyone. But we must make choices. We must live according to the values of the kingdom. Because at the end, God will separate the good from the bad. The third and final point is in the last part of the gospel. Here it says here that every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. Ito isa tong pagpapahiwatig ayon sa mga pantas, according to biblical commentaries and scholars, that what this means is that when we are called by God to mission, it doesn't mean sometimes iba meron tayong immediately, no, yung kailangan lahat, we must give up everything and just go and follow Christ. While that is true, remember we talked about this weeks ago about detachment. What this statement of the Lord is saying, both the new and the old, is that when we see our mission, I think it is important to see what are the blessings, what are our gifts that we can use in the service of the mission. Again, looking at it from Ignatius's point of view, you know, that's why I always tell people what I like with Ignatius is when you look at Ignatius, we can almost say kay Ignatius walang naaksaya. Because he himself says that the moment we discover God's mission for us, we must reorient everything in our life towards serving that mission. Everything. Reorient. Redirect everything. Our passion, our gifts, our sinfulness, you know, as we reorient it towards serving the mission is also giving it up, overcoming that sinful nature in us. But everything must be oriented towards the mission. And this is what basically the Lord says, that we must both use both the new and the old. Yun ho ang sinasabi ng Panginoon, na lahat ay dapat ialay natin sa pagsasakatuparan ng misyon. Hindi lamang dasal, kundi lahat ng ating mga galing, mga talino, kakayahan, lahat ito ay dapat natin pagnilayan at tanungin natin, ito ba ay makakatulong sa pagsasabuhay ko ng misyon? And again, Ignatius says, no, everything can be directed towards the greater glory of God. That everything is potentially a channel of God's grace. And today we pray for that. We pray for the lessons of this parable, or of this gospel rather, that more and more we will dedicate ourselves totally to God's mission. And part of our total dedication and total devotion to the mission despite setbacks that sometimes we will, very often rather, we will encounter, is knowing that in the end, God's will, God's justice, and God's mission will be brought to completion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us heed the invitation of God our Father for us to choose what is important, and that we may dedicate all our gifts towards the serving of His, towards His service in establishing His kingdom. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Father and the bishops may be guided and inspired by the wisdom of the gospel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may use the material gifts necessary for our well-being in a proper way and not become victims of greed and selfishness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are searching for the truth may daily come to a deeper appreciation of faith in Jesus Christ as the pearl of great price, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and those who are affected by the virus, and also those, and may those who also care for them, may be blessed in their sacrifices, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have departed, especially those who died due to the virus, may rest in eternal peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And again, we continue to ask you to, I'd like to ask you to pray for the Philippine Church and our bishops. And most especially, we ask for your prayers for the ABS-CBN family as it goes through very challenging times. And together, we invite you to pray with us the Kapamilya prayer.
Father in heaven, watch over us, our ABS-CBN family, all our employees, our leaders, friends, and supporters, Kapamilyas all. Grant us the grace to feel more deeply your presence in all that we are going through now. Experience more powerfully your loving providence. Saint Joseph, you believed in your dreams that made it possible for your son to fulfill his mission, our salvation. Make us continue to believe in our dreams and in one another. Please care for us, especially our Kapamilyas affected by the retrenchment, as you cared for Jesus and Mary. Blessed Mother, in our moment of need, place us with your Son, and may we do whatever he tells us. Embrace us, most especially our affected Kapamilyas, with your motherly protection. Come, Lord Jesus, in the midst of our challenges, and lead us along the path of the mission you have called us to be in the service of the Filipino. Our confidence and hope is in you alone, and in your eternal assurance that in the tender mercy of our God, by which the rising sun will come to us from heaven, to shine on those living in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the path of peace. We shall overcome. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the power working, through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially those who passed away during this time of the pandemic. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace the unity and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted, may they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them and grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the Passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace and joy to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.